back courtside. Phil Hazen reporting in what is a tight ball game, one of three ball games going on tonight that is going to determine who will hold down the last playoff spot in the D-League. One of the three teams vying for it is the Fort Wayne Mad Ants. Sykes for Sioux Falls, a spinning move from the baseline, and he has 21. We want to remind you, as we always do, this is a simulcast broadcast. The game is airing both on radio and television tonight. Lazar, double team, fadeaway jumper baseline, swish, he puts it in. Darnell Lazar with 20. Boy, he's had some big game for the Mad Ants this year. Here is Coleman in the forecourt. Chest pass up top. Well, either Texas, Idaho, or Fort Wayne will go to the playoffs. Here is McCray, and he knocks down the home run ball. McCray with 13. Well, Sioux Falls is hoping to end some of the drama tonight with a victory. Foul Raymond Sykes. He has his second. And that is the first team foul on the Skyforce. Coming at 5:10 remaining in the quarter. Phillips, Lazar at the foul line. Kramer, 16 to shoot. Goes opposite the screen, pulls up on a 20-footer, just kissed the rim in the front, and the rebound to Sean Marshall. To the right hand, drops it off to McCray in the forecourt. Backdoor cut, and Sykes with a chin-up slam! Raymond Sykes. Boy, he got in there. That one looked like it was played at high speed on the replay machine. Man, did he flush that one fast. Howard to Lazar. Tries to back down on Sykes. Fadeaway jumper. Oh, and he got it in. Some shot. That ball just hung up there, and it went in. It was like a magnet pulled it down. That ties the score at 77 apiece. McCray, it's fed over. Sean Marshall for the lead. Nope, kicks it out instead. Here's McCray on a two ball, wide right. The rebound to Ron Howard. Mad Ants, basket. Mad Ants take the lead. Ryan Whitman, a push shot from the baseline, missed it. He wasn't far enough out. Fight for the rebound, out to half court, and Chris Kramer gets it. Mad Ants will reload. Kramer down the lane, plows to the basket and a foul. Foul was called on Chris McCray. And Chris has his first and the team's second. We're going to pause 10 seconds and allow our stations to identify themselves. You're listening to the D-League tonight. Chris Kramer now has 17 points as he drops in the first foul shot. He has one more. Well, let's see, Corey Allman back in for Fort Wayne. Sykes to the bench, so Agunye is in, and let's say Scales has joined in. Kramer gets the second one in. He now has 18, and Fort Wayne's lead is 2. There's a ball tipped to the sideline, out of bounds. Texas leads Austin by 4. But, you know, Idaho played 2 down there. The best they could do was a split. And for Fort Wayne hopefuls, they're hoping that that's the exact same thing that happens to Texas. If Texas wins that game, it's all over. And the Legends will have a legendary season going, the former Colorado 14ers. Here's a steal. Kramer on the drive. Beautiful up and under move. And Sean Marshall fouled him. Hand went up immediately. That was a professional foul. That was a professional foul. It was to stop him from getting the basket, make him earn him at the line. Third team foul. Kramer at the line. A lot of buzz around the arena tonight. The Butler University Bulldogs, for the second straight year, have earned a trip to the NCAA Finals. They defeated Virginia Commonwealth. I don't know the score. 82-77, now 81-77. Kramer has hit 4 straight foul shots here in the second half and 6 straight for the game. He has 20, and the Fort Wayne Mad Ants lead is at 4. Agunye, far side, it goes to Coleman. on the baseline. Sean Marshall up and firing. He rolled it over the top. Rebound went to Lazar. It looked like Matt Ansel will run it up. No, it's Wayne Chisholm, excuse me. Now Lazar gets it off the block. Nearly lost it. Out front to Kramer. Pump fake on a three. Gets it to Almond. He'll shoot a three. Got it! Corey Almond has a total of 8. 2 home runs for him in the game. And the lead is up to 7. 84-77 Fort Wayne. Sykes is getting up. He'll come back in. Agunye to Marshall. Fed over. 3 ball from the left wing side. Left short. Rebound fought for Lazar. Ahead of the pack. Corey Almond driving in. Scores! Corey Almond, the Mad Ants are blowing and going. They're getting the ball out on the break. And they have a 9-point lead at 86-77. McCray threw a double team to the baseline, kicked in the corner. Marshall on a pump fake, penetrates over the middle, gets it off the glass. No, rebound Scales in traffic, feeds it over, and Coleman has it. So the Skyforce will reload. Out front it is McCray. Boy, this has been an end-to-end game. It has been an exciting game. There's a feed inside, whistle. Scales got it. He had a little jump hook in there. And Chris Kramer is the guy who gets the foul, and we will pause. We have 2:04 remaining. Okay, back here courtside, Bill Hazen back with our crack broadcast crew. Scott Majors is spinning the dials with smiles, as we used to say in the radio business, but actually it's more like punching all the buttons, and brother, he has a lot of them to punch. Looks like he's working on a NASA rocket project next to me here. Great crew that brings the pictures for our future cast viewers. Now we had a, how about that? Sioux Falls lost track of the time, as did your favorite announcer, by the way. I must admit, McCray, I thought they had more time on there. That confused me, too. I think I caught everybody by surprise. Well, what happened? I started talking about Scott Majors. I forgot all about the shot clock. Shame on me. 86-77. Wayne Chisholm in. Almond around a screen from Lazar. Whoop, Almond lost it. He hooked the ball over. Out. No, foul call. The foul went to Chris McCray. His second, team's fourth. Last common foul, Almond will trigger it to Chris Kramer. It is hooked over. Now to Lazar, off the block on the right. Sykes defending. Lazar over the middle, a gigantic hook shot, and he put it in. Lazar has 24. Wow, what a ball game. His season high is 36, by the way. McCray to the baseline. Lazar has been so wonderful this year. A lot of fun to watch. Scales down the lane. Kicks it over, chest pass to Marshall at three-point range. Back, 3 ball by Coleman. He lifted short. Randy Whitman with a jumping rebound. Fort Wayne has the ball back and an 11-point lead, their largest. 3 ball on the way by Allman. Whoops, didn't get it. Chisholm tried to keep it alive, but McCray grabs the rebound after Scales got it. Now Scales with a baseline jumper, and whoa, he shot that one too long. 2 feet long on the shot. Fort Wayne on the rebound. Kramer on the drive. Lob for Lazar. There was a foul in traffic. Foul went against Chris McCray. That's number 3 on him. Sioux Falls has to be careful here because there's a chance that somebody could foul out. Well, you've heard all about the importance of education today. We hear about it all the time. Here's a good idea for getting an education without ever having to pay for it. Just listen to Viewpoint University every day, 4 to 7, on KSOO 1140. Fun show each day with Ruth and Rick. And they're always on good decorum, those two. So we invite you to tune in. All of our Sioux Falls and South Dakota listeners invite you to tune in and catch it. Viewpoint University on KSOO 1140. After the miss, rebound. Foul, and we'll just see who got it. They gave the foul to Wayne Chisholm. His second. Anthony Kent is back in for Fort Wayne. I'll tell you what, I'm tearing up this chart tonight. All right. Sioux Falls with the ball. Fourth team foul, by the way. Scales gets it down on the block, tries to go up. Stoned! Anthony Kent knocked it away out of bounds. Let's see. Sioux Falls, I think, gets the ball. Boy, Anthony Kent with a great block shot there. And Mo McCone up off the bench, you might have been able to hear him in the background saying, get it in, get it in. So let's see, now the officials want to talk about it and say, now who was it who last touched the ball? And nobody is sure. So the best thing to do in a case like that, if you aren't sure, see if you can get a consensus. It's kind of like politics, you know. Although I don't know how good we're doing at consensus building in politics these days. Not very well. Let's see now. They're going to reset. The issue was the shot clock. Sioux Falls has it back. They're going to set the shot clock at 8 seconds. Sioux Falls will toss it in under the Mad Ants defensive basket to the left. McCray is the trigger man. Lob Sykes the target. He reached up and got it and shot it inside. Settle. Raymond Sykes with 22. That was some shot. Mad Ants 89, Skyforce 79. In the forecourt, Kramer, Chisholm on a high screen. Kramer goes around it, feeds Whitman on a pump fake, penetrates Kramer, open for three, wide right, long rebound. That's the end of the quarter. And so we will go to the fourth quarter of this ball game. One quarter remaining in the regular season for the Mad Ants. Our score on the ball game, the Mad Ants 89, the Skyforce 79.